What should your student loan payments be post-pandemic? I'm Travis from Student Loan Planner. I personally advised over $500 million in student loan debt, and we're getting a lot of questions from people that are wondering what will happen to their student loan repayment after the payment and interest freeze ends in September. So I thought this would be a good video to talk about the way federal repayment worked before the pandemic, how we expect it's going to work after the pandemic, what to expect in terms of the changes that we might see, how to prepare for payments getting started, and then how to pick the best repayment plan for you. So first, let's talk about the way federal repayment worked on student loans before the pandemic. Basically, what would happen is you would graduate with federal student loan debt, and then you would get about 6 months before you had to make your first payment. This is called the grace period after graduation. Now, some people could get out of that by consolidating their loans and speeding up that process, which for a lot of people makes sense to do that. But generally speaking, if you do absolutely nothing, which certainly a lot of people, that was their preferred route, they would not make any payments until they were asked to do so, which generally took about 6 months after graduation. Then once they were asked to make payments, they would be asked to decide if they wanted to be on the standard 10-year plan or if they wanted to be on a plan where they would pay based on their income. So a lot of people would say, I want to pay based on my income, particularly if you have a large amount of debt relative to your income. The student loan servicer would ask for your tax returns or other documentation proving your income, and then your payments would start up, and you would have 12 months for that payment that would last according to the documents you submitted. Then they would ask you for your income certification again with new income information, probably from your most recent available tax return. So that's kind of how the repayment worked before the pandemic. If you needed a forbearance, you would simply call up your student loan servicer and say, hey, I'm dealing with a period of economic hardship. Could you pause my loans? Now, unfortunately, a lot of people didn't get the full benefit of income-driven repayment because whenever your payment falls, you're able to call your loan servicer and request that they recalculate it to a lower number. Unfortunately, a lot of people don't know that. And so that's why in the pandemic, politicians decided, let's just pause all of it, pause the interest, pause the payments, and just give people credit for all forgiveness programs that they're working for. Unfortunately, there were a few loans that were not included in this, specifically loans that were bank-owned that were under a program that existed before 2010 called the FFEL Loan Repayment Program. Those loans, unfortunately, were not included in this interest and payment freeze. But that's how the payments worked before the pandemic. You had a bunch of different options to choose from. Generally speaking, you would either enter into a plan where you're paying at least the interest and a little bit of principal every month, or you're in an income-driven plan where your loan can be what's called negatively amortizing, which just means a fancy word for the loan is growing in size instead of shrinking because you're not paying off the interest every month. Now, with the pandemic, interest and payments were paused. So that brings me to my second point. The first point was, what was federal repayment like pre-pandemic? Now let's talk about what federal payments are going to be like on student loans post-pandemic. So post-pandemic, if you were already in an income-driven plan, your payments are going to start up again on the same income-driven repayment plan. Now, what that payment's going to be depends on whether or not your student loan servicer asked you for your income recertification documents already. Now, if they have, then it's a good chance that your payments are going to be based on that new information. So that new information will reflect your new income, probably from tax year 2020, and you will have to most likely pay based on that tax return. Now, there are some people who will have not filed their 2020 tax return yet, or will not be being asked for their 2020 tax return yet. So let me give you an example. People who have a recertification date in between January and March of 2021, a lot of those people were not asked to recertify at that time. And even if they were able to use 2019's tax return instead of 2020's tax return. So a lot of people will begin payments again based off of their older tax returns that they have submitted all the way back in March of 2020 when this whole pandemic interest and payment pause started. So you really need to check with your servicer if you've not been asked for your income documentation and you still don't get asked between now and September, there's a good chance that post-pandemic your payments will be based off of your old income information. If, however, you have been asked for your income information, you'll probably have to pay based off of that newer tax return, which could result in a higher or a lower monthly payment depending on what happened to your income during that time. Now, what will happen to the income-driven repayment programs. There's a big desire to simplify and consolidate all these different repayment programs into a new single repayment option for student loan borrowers. That's probably going to happen at some point. We just don't know when, and we don't know what the details of that repayment program will be. It's been discussed that borrowers should be allowed to stay in the repayment program that they like if they want to by simply opting out of the new plan whenever it does become available, or they can be automatically included into the new one, whichever they prefer. So that's what we're expecting. We do think that this payment and interest pause might provide an opportunity for Congress to and the White House to look at reforming the student loan system, because it really presents a perfect opportunity given everything's paused at the stoplight, sort of waiting for the green light to go with payments and interest again, right? So we'll see what happens. There certainly will be a lot of noise around student loans when payments and interest start again, because it's just going to be this massive thing that's going to happen all at once when hopefully the pandemic is somewhat under control and the economy is doing fine. So if those are things are true, we could see a lot of movement, a lot of loud noise surrounding what will happen in the future of payment plans and what the income-driven repayment plans will be. Now that said, it's going to be way too soon to start a new income-driven repayment plan and implement that all by September 30th, 2021. That is way too fast for all that to happen. So we would anticipate that they would begin discussions about student loan reform in the spring or summer of 2021. Maybe they would come out with a bill, but it wouldn't take place probably for a little while. They'll probably try to get everyone back in repayment because a lot of the contracts with the student loan servicers expire at the end of 2021. So it's going to be a big mess if they don't start repayments around September. So that's what we expect will happen with federal repayment post-pandemic. How, like, what should you expect? Like, what do you think is going to happen, right? What will happen with student loan repayments? Well, again, your payment is just going to start probably around the end of October. That's our third point, is what should you expect? We think payments are going to start around the end of October because the interest and payment pause ends at the end of September, which means it's about 30 days after that when payments and interest will begin for most people. So really, you could think of, you know, here's a good way to remember this. Halloween is scary. Student loans are scary. Your first payment will probably start around Halloween of 2021. And that's, you know, at least that's more time than we thought we were going to get. 18 months almost of paused payments and interest is certainly something that's been a welcome reprieve for a lot of student loan borrowers. Do we think that, should we expect any cancellation, student loan cancellation? Probably not. We're not expecting a broad-based amount of student loan cancellations because it's very expensive if you look at the cost of it. Now, if President Biden's not going to do it via executive order, that means Congress would have to do it. And if Congress has to do it, it means it has to be paid for with a tax increase or a spending reduction, which we think is something that Congress is not going to want to particularly do, given President Biden's comments in public about not supporting 50,000 of cancellation. So we'll see what happens, but we would expect your payments and interest to begin again sometime in the fall of 2021. Now, how to prepare for this? That's my fourth point. How can you prepare for federal repayment to begin again in 2021? You just simply need to call your loan servicer and ask them, what is my expected payment going to be when this payment interest freeze ends? It's probably a good time to call them because fewer people are calling them because of the student loan payment and interest freeze. They're going to get a gazillion calls around September after Labor Day. And this is going to be a really weird time because a lot of these businesses are going to have to lay a lot of people off because their contracts expire at the end of 2021. So we would suggest that you contact your loan servicer to figure out what your payment will be on your income-driven plan when the payment and interest freeze does end. And when you know what that is, at least you can be prepared. We actually have on studentloanplanner.com a lot of calculator tools that you could use. If you just go to the resources section and look at all of our calculators on our website, we have an income-driven calculator that you can use with the latest 2021 poverty line numbers where you can estimate what your payment is going to be after the payment and interest pause ends. Now, the very last point I've got for you is, how do you know what payment plan is ideal for you? What I would suggest is that you watch our next video so that you can see the best federal and income-driven repayment programs ranked from worst to best. And it's more than just that. Obviously, you can also hire us for a student loan plan, and we'll do the analysis for you and figure it out. Studentloanplanner.com/help is the URL for that. But watch the next video on the best student loan repayment programs ranked so you can find out what the best federal repayment program will be for your loans in 2021.